that green light. Give me that green light name. Give me that green light. Give me that green light name. Give me that green light. Give me that green light name. Give me that green light. Give me that green light name.
Tonight's Green Light Maine is sponsored by Thomas Mosier Furniture, handmade American furniture since 1972.
Welcome to Green Light Maine for a winner's mentoring session. Here on Green Light Maine, we are helping to grow Maine's economy one dream at a time. I'm Don Gooding, your show host and a member of Maine Angels. And with us in the studio is Kathy Langelier from Herbal Revolution, as well as three mystery mentors who are going to be helping her to address one of the growth challenges that she's facing. Now, I'm going to introduce all of you in just a few minutes. But first, Kathy, congratulations on advancing to the next round of Green Light Maine. I'm hoping everything's still going well with your company.
Things are going great. Thank you so much for having me. It's very exciting to be here.
Well, I think I remember enjoying your pitch, but I think what we want to do now is show the pitch so that the mentors and I and the audience can remember what your business is all about. So please roll the tape. Take it away, Catherine.
Thank you so much for having me. I was born and raised in our beautiful state of Maine, and for the past 20 years, I have been studying plant-based medicine with a focus on plants that grow here in our state. I have a certified organic farm where I grow herbs and vegetables that go into my tonic, tea, elixir, and drinking vinegar lines. Now, 90% of healthcare costs are due to stress-related illnesses, and 3 out of 4 doctor's visits are due to stress. I look to my communities to see what the focus is, what the needs are of the communities, and from there, I create products to support those needs. So a lot of my formulations have a focus on nervous system, immune system, and digestive support. I also try to create my products to be, of course, delicious, and I make them versatile. My goal is to have them be part of everybody's daily life. I take that food is medicine and medicine is food approach. So I don't want them to just use it once in a while. I really want this to be a lifestyle. My customers are health conscious folks. They shop at Whole Foods, they shop at co-ops, natural food stores, Wegmans. The organic industry itself is a $43.3 billion industry and growing. And the herbal supplement industry is projected to be at $115 billion by 2020. So the demand is there. There's a great demand for high quality products such as mine. I also feel that being from Maine and having a Maine product has a lot of national appeal as well. Since starting my business in 2010, it has been steadily growing. Some years it has doubled in growth. This year it's projected at a 45% growth rate. In 2014, I was able to quit my other jobs and start working full-time for my business. And in 2015, I started working with Pulp and Wire to start rebranding the lines to give it that more nationwide appeal. At this point, I'm in over 100 stores, and I work with the North Atlantic region of Whole Foods. And coming this fall, my tonic line is going to be going national, which is really exciting, but it definitely comes with its challenges as well. And so at this point, I'm trying to definitely look at what those challenges are and what my needs are. I have confidence in the brand itself. I do believe that this is a national brand, but right now what I need to do is create the resources that I need to make sure, to ensure the success of the brand.
So Kathy, that was 6 months ago that you gave the pitch. How do you feel about that today?
I feel good about the pitch, having it be my first ever, so I'm...
Oh, first ever,
yes,
yeah.
So I feel pretty okay with it.
Yeah, scary experience.
So scary.
So what sort of things have been happening in your business in the last 6 months?
Really similar to what I was talking about back in the pitch. I'm still trying to put together resources to help support the marketing...
Yes, always one of those challenges.
Yes.
Well, I think we'll probably get to that in our discussions with the mentors. So I'd like to take this opportunity to introduce our mystery mentors. Hope you don't mind. I'm just going to introduce them by their first names, nothing about their backgrounds until the end of the show. So I'd like to introduce Elena, welcome to Greenlight Maine.
Thank you for having me.
And in the middle, we have Mark. I appreciate you being here today, Mark.
Thank you for having me.
You ready to be a good mentor and ask lots of good questions?
Absolutely.
And then finally, at the end, Laura. Again, welcome to Greenlight Maine.
Great to be here. Congratulations.
Thank you.
So I think we are just about ready to tackle your problem. But before that, we're going to take a short break, after which we'll be back and we'll find out which of the many challenges we're going to talk about again with Kathy and Herbal Revolution. See you in a minute.
Greenlight Maine would like to thank the Maine Department of Economic and Community Development, the Maine DECD, helping businesses and communities prosper.
I'm George Gervais, Commissioner of the Maine Department of Economic and Community Development. At the department, we work tirelessly to improve Maine's competitiveness. If your business needs help navigating through red tape and regulations, or is looking to invest or expand, our team of governor's account executives is a great resource. Government can't create jobs. It's our goal to become your partner, making Maine a better place to visit, study, and invest.
Hi, I'm Lori LaChance, president of Thomas College. Our graduate and undergraduate programs prepare you for success in your personal and professional life and for leadership and service in your community. I know firsthand the value of a Thomas degree. My Thomas MBA completely changed the trajectory of my career, giving me opportunities I would never have had without it. Thomas College provides a great education that is personal, relevant, affordable, and guaranteed.
We're standing by and ready for the call.
I need you out on 202.
We gotta get the hospital back online. In any weather, under any conditions, we're ready. When you lose power, there's one thing you can count on. We'll be ready to roll.
Please join us to find vital information on our website at greenlightmaine.com and be a part of our vibrant community on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Together, we're building Maine's future, one dream at a time.
We're back on Greenlight Maine, and we are ready to tackle the challenge that Kathy has in her business. Please pay attention at home because maybe you can be of some help. So, Kathy, all businesses at your stage of development have lots and lots of challenges. So which one of the many would you like to focus on today?
I think I'd like to focus on creating a team. Right now, I'm still just a one-person operation, and I'm starting to really see the effects of being a one-person operation. And so I'd like to figure out, what does it look like creating a team to help me move forward into 2017?
Classic problem many growing companies face. So, Elena, first question over to you.
Are you considering co-packing or keeping your product in-house, or what are you thinking about?
So right now, I am considering keeping it in-house. Okay. I'm also looking at a manufacturing facility. So that's part of the plans for 2017.
Okay.
For now, that's the plan.
Mark, next question.
By the way, congratulations on your growth. I think it's fantastic.
Thank you.
And I think you have a great line of products. So, you know, as far as the team goes, that is a challenge. I would presume I've never started a business, but working in a business, I've had to form many teams. But I think in your special situation, you probably will want to look for somebody who's good in supply chain, somebody who knows quality, who knows manufacturing, who knows equipment. Has the network of people and so forth to help you out.
Maybe turning that into a question, have you tried to start looking for those kind of people who might have that kind of a background?
To a degree. MEP, I reached out to MEP, Maine
Manufacturing Extension Partnership.
Yeah, to kind of help me see how I could work with the manufacturing piece of it. And I have that actually written into my plan for the 2017 to do some work with them.
Okay, Laura, next question.
So, Kathy, I haven't tried your product, but I look forward to going out tonight to try it. And so what is your passion, and what are you uniquely qualified to do that it wouldn't be Herbal Revolutions if you weren't doing it?
Yeah, I grow plants. I'm a farmer, and so I work with plants, and I formulate. So what my passion is taking the plants and the vegetables that I work with and creating products with them. I love doing that, and that's really what my greatest skill is for the business.
That's a great question and a very important one, and I'm glad that you know the answer to that. Mm-hmm. Elena, next question.
So what is your marketing plan? Kind of, what are you thinking about in how to get your product, and what does it look like? Are you working with certain distributors, or are you... Tell me a little bit about that.
Yeah, I'm currently right now in about 143 stores, and I have one distributor that is in the New England region who is taking care of my Whole Foods accounts and some smaller independent stores in New England. My plan right now, and I'll say the marketing piece is challenging as a sole person, and I haven't had a lot of time to do marketing. Really, people have been coming to me. But my goal for 2017 is to have more of a push. Instead of, in 2016, and in my pitch, I mentioned national. And I do really want to see the brand go national, but I'm kind of reining back a little bit and wanting to focus more on New England and the East Coast and kind of going for larger stores like groceries, like Wegmans and Hannaford's.
Next question, Mark.
Yes, so I was wondering, as you grow, and presumably you have property to do your farming, mm-hmm. are you gonna have the capacity to maintain your growth? Because 45% growth is, you know, in your first year is pretty impressive. And if you kind of project that out, I wanna make sure that, you know, you have the, resources to continue that growth.
Yeah, the farm will be able to, like the farm itself and producing that, I can probably produce at least 50% of the ingredients that go into the products at the farm. But as I grow, that is gonna be an issue. And I'm right now looking out facilities that are close to the farm so that I can expand.
Okay, so I think we're at the time now where I'm going to ask the mystery mentors for some of their initial thoughts. So, Laura, since you didn't get the second question, I'm actually going to ask you for some of your initial thoughts on this challenge of growing the team.
Okay. So, if I could have asked a question, I would have asked what revolution means to you, because you named Herbal Revolution for a reason. So, mm-hmm. tapping into what your vision is for the future and what revolution means. And, you know, you can attract people with that vision and also customers. So really living that through social media and through your recruitment efforts, I think would be very exciting.
Great thoughts to make sure that the team shares the vision. Elena, some initial thoughts?
Just make sure that you have like a supply, you're working with your suppliers, and if you're growing at such a large rate, you might wanna think about outsourcing at some point. That's going to probably be your biggest challenge, is figuring out how to outsource. The team will grow with you.
And figuring out, because that helps solve some of the people problems as well. And Mark, some initial thoughts?
Yeah, I think the people piece is very important. And, you know, I heard about your passion, and I think if you could surround yourself with folks that work for you with that same passion and interest, it will make your company that much more, let's say, grounded in what you want to accomplish.
Absolutely.
Great. So these are some wonderful initial thoughts on the challenge, not only related to the people side, but you know, people are connected to everything else. Yeah. So I'm going to give you a little time to think about what of all of those thoughts you want to concentrate on in our next segment, and we will be back in just a few minutes. In the meantime, we'd love to hear your thoughts about what Kathy perhaps ought to be doing to face this challenge of going from a single person to a multi-employee company. Feel free to post those thoughts on Twitter at #GreenlightMaine or on our Facebook page. We'll be back after a break here on Greenlight Maine.
Handmade carpets for Greenlight Maine have been provided by Mugalian Rugs, area rugs from around the world.
As a leader in Maine and New England in providing integrated accounting, consulting, and tax services to clients large and small, the team at MacPage has proven to provide innovative solutions to help us better meet our clients' needs. We enjoy the people we serve and care about the work we do. The success of our business is based upon our ability to develop quality relationships, one client at a time. MacPage, accessible, approachable, accountable.
The Amazing Music of Mainers is a two-CD set of 26 songs by many of Maine's most famous recording artists.
I'm just a damn star hero, falling in a tailspin.
This two-CD set is available at all Bull Moose and Maine credit unions.
I will take from the reach all that she has to do.
And online at mainvillepublishing.com.
You can help out if you want to.
Inch by inch.
A lot of what happens on Greenlight Maine occurs between commercial breaks and at the end of our shows. To see more in-depth discussions between our entrepreneurs and their mentors, go to greenlightmaine.com and click on Behind the Scenes.
In 1972, Tom Moser committed his life's work to craft, and four decades later employs 70 fine craftsmen and women in our shop in Auburn, Maine. With showrooms and customers from coast to coast and numerous awards and accolades, Tom has firmly established himself as an entrepreneurial tour de force and has proven that a life doing what you love is indeed possible.
This year's winner of Greenlight Maine will win this handmade Thomas Moser beacon box and $100,000. Greenlight Maine would like to thank Maine Startup and Create Week, a conference worth skipping work for.
Welcome back to Greenlight Maine. We've heard about Kathy's challenge at Herbal Revolution. We've had a pretty wide-ranging discussion with our mystery mentors. So among all of those things, Kathy, what would you like to focus some of the remaining discussion on?
Yeah, thanks. I think I'd like to focus on hiring people in the sense of for marketing help, and what would that look like? Would it look like hiring a consulting group per project, and marketing online as well as wholesale accounts?
Wide ranging. So, Elena, some initial thoughts there?
I think that's good because you're not taking up your time, which is making the product, of marketing it. I think that takes a lot of off your plate. And consulting firms do work because you might not have the expertise, but they will. You could hire someone in-house, but you'd have to have some capital to make sure that you keep them. And good ones need to be paid well.
Yeah.
So.
Okay.
Mark, some additional
yes,
thoughts
Yes, I would agree.
There.
And I would say the e-commerce feels like you would have a real great opportunity right now to accelerate market and also test, right? Because you can also get feedback very easily, quickly, inexpensively, mm-hmm. and I think that's what you need.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Laura, and building on that?
Going back to the revolution, I think there's such a potential in building up this community of customers through social media and just having them share how they're using the product and whether it's on Facebook or a blog, but just have more of the presence of this is healthy, this is Maine, and this is something that we all can be loyal behind and share and learn from each other.
So I'm going to bring up the tough issue of funding such a person, because that's always the thing. It's like, yeah, great, go hire somebody. And then it's like, well, look at my wallet here.
Yeah.
So I want to maybe think creatively. First of all, if as the business is today, what kind of budget on a monthly basis would you be able to have for such a marketing person? And maybe we can try to think through just a couple ideas of how you might be able to get some more money out of that.
Yeah, I am creating a budget for this, and with capital, I'm trying to search for grants as well and seek out that. Although that's not a guarantee, of course.
Of course.
You know, but it is helping me kind of create a budget for marketing, and I think that the budget does look more like a consultant. As opposed, I've been trying to figure that out, and honestly, I think that hiring somebody for this might be so challenging in and of itself, and having that consistent funding I was a little concerned about. So I like the idea of a consulting firm and maybe working on projects or per project maybe.
Yeah, I think that sounds like the right way to go. And so hopefully with the additional grant money, you'll be able to increase that budget over time. Well, our mystery mentors were kind of united with that recommendation. So I think it's now time for them to reveal who they actually are. So, Elena.
Hello, my name is Elena Metzger, and I'm the vice president of Print Bangor, a full-service print shop.
In Bangor, no doubt.
Yes.
As if that needs to be said. Mark?
Mark DeBravolny. I am with Colgate-Palmolive, and I do strategic innovation and technology and alliances.
And before it was called Colgate-Palmolive, it was?
Toms of Maine.
Toms of Maine. Yes. Yes. And finally, Laura.
I am Laura Young. I'm a vice president of the Maine Community Foundation. And one of our goals is to encourage entrepreneurial innovation. And we partner with business leaders who love Maine and want to make a difference.
Nice. So we've got lots of resources here. Mm-hmm. Now that you know who they are, any immediate question jump into your mind for any of these folks?
Well, I'm just thinking of printing. Well, I should talk with you after.
Yeah.
you know.
Yeah, because Maine Community Foundation actually has some impact investing
exactly,
now.
Exactly, yes. And we hold Maine Accelerates Growth Fund, which is connected with the whole entrepreneurial world.
Oh, interesting.
In Maine.
Yeah. So more resources there. And then on the manufacturing side, you've been involved in that quite a bit as well. So lots of resources that we have brought to the table here.
I love it.
Again, any immediate questions? Because we can certainly come back after a short break.
Well, the manufacturing piece, I mean, Tom started, I'm assuming, small, like where I'm at, and watching how that works, like keeping the quality. You talked a bit about that, and that is a concern of mine. It's so important to keep that quality control, which is why I think that I want to keep it in-house as opposed to going out of house. But I'm just wondering what that looked like with the growth of Tom's, and if you had, like, where Tom's was when I was at
I don't know whether you can answer that in like 10 seconds or less.
No, you can't. That's why I mentioned is that, you know, you talked about your team and the people.
Yeah.
You know, when the time comes, and it feels like it's coming very quickly, having somebody who understands supply chain will be worth your money.
Really important.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, so with that, we're going to have to take a short break, and we'll be back with some final thoughts here on Greenlight Maine.
Furniture for Greenlight Maine is provided by Thomas Mosier Furniture, handmade American furniture since 1972.
Hi, I'm Lori LaChance, president of Thomas College. Our graduate and undergraduate programs prepare you for success in your personal and professional life and for leadership and service in your community. I know firsthand the value of a Thomas degree. My Thomas MBA completely changed the trajectory of my career, giving me opportunities I would never have had without it. Thomas College provides a great education that is personal, relevant, affordable, and guaranteed.
I think people walk into our store because they know we're going to treat them well, and they know they're going to get a good value for whatever they're looking at.
It's definitely something that you don't see at large corporate chains that have lost that real personal touch that we try to keep up with every day.
At Days, we constantly show that we care. They know that we're going to take care of them for years to come. It's not a one sale and done. We want to build customers for a lifetime.
Make sure that my jewelry comes from Days.
I'm George Gervais, Commissioner of the Maine Department of Economic and Community Development. At the department, we're focused on making sure Maine people have the opportunity to build wealth. We do that through targeted activities aimed at retaining and creating jobs, marketing our beautiful state to millions of visitors, businesses, and marketing for workforce talent, helping new products and services and ideas commercialize, and getting Maine businesses access to new markets across the world, improving our competitiveness, making Maine open for business.
Broadcast facilities provided by NESCOM, the New England School of Communications at Husson University.
We're back, and thanks in advance for posting your ideas on Facebook. We're going to get some final thoughts from our mentors, as well as from Kathy of Herbal Revolution. So first, Elena, we talked about a lot of things. Some final thoughts for Kathy?
I love your brand, and I think you should grow it slowly. I would contract out, but maybe you should focus in on your manufacturing and making it as efficient as possible. And I know we discussed some outside resources that would really help you.
Focus. Mark, some
yes,
thoughts there.
I would echo that as well. I think you have a great brand opportunity. You're growing. So focus will be sort of the priority. And you mentioned you have a plan. I think you should probably prioritize and say, these are the things I must get done. You know, don't try to make it big and broad. Just very focused on the things you have to do. And then just implement the plan.
Laura,
I agree with focus, and I would add courage to that, because you have a great vision, you've got a great product, you know, you've made it through the tough part. Now it's just taking it to the next stage, and I think you'll do great.
Well, Kathy, yeah. Those are some highly encouraging and focusing thoughts. What sort of things are you going to do perhaps a little bit differently coming out of this show?
Well, I first thank you all so much. I really appreciated what you've shared. And yeah, I think production plans is going to be at the top of my list. And I'm really grateful for the advice on reaching out to a consulting group for the marketing piece. I think that that's been really helpful and important.
Excellent. So I think that will hopefully help you get through what is always a tough transition going from a solo entrepreneur to having eventually that dream team. I think we've between what we said on air and in between, lots and lots of ideas there. So best of luck, Kathy, with the coming year, as well as best of luck in that next stage of the Greenlight Maine competition. And speaking of that, for those of you in the audience, please watch our Facebook page as well as greenlightmaine.com for announcements about the rest of the competition. The plan is we're going to have a live event first to narrow down the 13 competitors to just 3, who will then go head to head to head in front of judges and a live audience for that grand championship, where one of the companies will walk away with $100,000. So you will have the opportunity to see that happen. We'll also let you know on Facebook and the website when we will start accepting video pitches for next year's competition. And remember, if you want to start your own business, like Kathy has done here, greenlightmaine.com has lots of resources for you. So keep dreaming big, keep supporting all the companies that you see here on the show as well as in your daily life. And together, the Greenlight Maine community can help grow Maine's economy one dream at a time. See you next time.
Greenlight Maine would not be possible without the support of all of our corporate sponsors. Thank you.
Give me that green light. Give me that green light, Maine. Give me that green light. Give me that green light, Maine.
Greenlight Maine has been a paid-for presentation by the Portland Media Group.